Good morning students, today's subject is science. Today we are going to see the new lesson, that is lesson number 15, fun with magnets. So the lesson number 15 is fun with magnets. I think everyone know the magnets, already you have played with magnets also, yes. Now see in the picture, here some picture shown. So here one picture is there, that is pin holder, yes, pin holder. Pins in a pin holder do not fall even when it is held upside down. Why is this so? Suppose if we take the pin holder and if we keep it as a upside down, is it that pins get fall? No, the pins do not fall. Then what happen? Why that pins do not fall? Yes, is it anyone know? Then again one example, while we are shutting the door of a fridge, we find that it closes automatically from a certain distance, okay, and does not open unless we pulled again. So why is this so? So why this happen? Though we pin holder we keep it in a upside down, the pins does not fall, and that fridge door also with a certain distance automatically it closed. Why this happen? Yes, is it, have you think what is the reason behind that? If we observe this carefully, they are having one scientific reason behind that. So what is that? That only we have to see in this lesson, okay. So in this object they are having the magnet, okay, in this gadget or in this instrument the magnet is used. A magnet is fitted in the cap of pin holder, that blue color cap is there, no? So in the inside that they have fit the magnet. Again in the door of fridge also they have the fitted the magnet, and as we know the magnet attracted iron objects, magnet attracted iron objects, and that pins are made up of iron, and so as we keep it upside down that cap attract the all pins as they are having the magnet. And for door also, as they are having the magnet is fitted in the fridge, it attract the iron objects. So in the door they are having the iron things, so it attract towards itself. Understood the reason behind that? Okay, now what is a magnet, how it found, that all things we have to see today. Now what is a magnet? The material to which objects made from iron, nickel, cobalt, etc. get attracted is called a magnet. Okay, what is a magnet? The material or anything to which objects are get attracted, which is made by the iron, nickel and cobalt. Then this property of material is called the magnetism, and their property is called magnetism. Now let's try this. Here I have one activity. We have to take one magnet, okay, and we have to take a different materials also, okay. So many things or material we have to take, and we have to check which material get attracted to this magnet or which material does not attract or does not stick. Now see, again we have to take a mixture of sand, piece of paper and sawdust, iron fillings, pins in a saucer. In a dish we have to take sand or piece of paper, sawdust, iron fillings, and we have to pass a magnet around a mixture. We have to pass a magnet around a mixture and we have to observe what happens. As we observe it carefully, from this dish some materials or some things get attracted towards magnet. Which things get attracted? For example, iron fillings or pins. Iron fillings and pins. Is it piece of paper get attracted or sawdust get attracted towards magnet? No. Okay. So the material that stick to a magnet are called magnetic materials. The material which stick to a magnet are called magnetic material, while those that do not stick to a magnet are called non-magnetic materials. The metal, iron, cobalt, nickel are magnetic materials. The metal, iron, cobalt, nickel, these are the magnetic materials. So understood everyone what is a magnet and the magnetic materials and non-magnetic materials. Now we have to see in the past what happened, how that magnet get discovered, how that magnet get discovered. There have one story behind that. Okay, the story of magnet. For better understanding, just see one clip.
This property of magnets is called magnetism. Discovery of magnets. Long ago in the country Greece, a shepherd named Magnus was living in a region called Magnesia. Once, while herding his sheep, he observed that the metal tip of his staff was getting stuck to a large black rock. The rock was a natural magnet, and the stick was attracted to it. Such types of magnetic rocks were called magnetite. Shapes of magnets. Lodestone is a natural magnet. It has an irregular shape. On the other hand, artificial magnets can be given any shape. Different shapes of an artificial magnet are bar magnet, horseshoe magnet, needle magnet, cylindrical magnet, magnetic and non-magnetic materials. Different types of materials are classified as magnetic materials and non-magnetic materials. Materials which get attracted by a magnet are called magnetic materials. For example, iron, steel, etc. Materials which do not get attracted by a magnet are called non-magnetic materials. For example, wood, plastic, etc. Poles of a magnet. Let us perform an activity to know about the poles of a magnet. Spread iron filings on a piece of paper. Place a magnet on it and shake the paper. It can be observed that the iron fillings stick near the ends of the magnet. These two ends of the magnet are called magnetic poles. The poles of a magnet always occur in pairs. It is impossible to obtain an isolated magnetic pole. An interesting property of a magnet is that when suspended, it comes to rest in the north-south direction. Let us perform an activity to justify this statement. Take a bar magnet and mark one of its ends for identification. Now tie a thread in the middle of the bar magnet and suspend it freely from a wooden stand. Give it a push and let it come to rest. Mark the rest positions of the magnet on the table. Join both the ends by drawing a line. Disturb the magnet from its original position. It can be observed that the magnet rests in the same position again. The end of the magnet that points towards the north is called the North Pole, while the end of the magnet that points towards the south is called the South Pole. Interaction between magnetic poles. Like poles of two magnets always repel each other, while the unlike poles of a magnet always attract each other. Let us perform an activity to show the interaction between poles of a magnet. Take a bar magnet A and suspend it freely from a wooden stand. Bring the north pole of another bar magnet B near the north pole of the magnet A. The north pole of the magnet A will repel in the opposite direction. Now bring the south pole of another bar magnet B near the south pole of the magnet A. The south pole of the magnet A will repel in the opposite direction. Thus, it is clear that the poles repel each other. Repeat the activity by bringing the north pole of another bar magnet B near the south pole of the magnet A. The south pole of the magnet A will get attracted towards the north pole of magnet B. Now bring the south pole of another bar magnet B near the north pole of the magnet A. The north pole of the magnet A will get attracted towards the south pole of magnet B. Thus, it is clear that unlike poles attract each other.
I think everyone have understood the story of magnet. Because of that shepherd, the magnet were discovered. In that clip, we have seen the different types of magnets and their properties also. Okay. Again, there are detailed properties I am going to explain in next video.